D-Day for Crown Princess Mary of Denmark. The Australian-born royal set to take the throne as Queen. The day's events promising to deliver large crowds and fanfare to mark the royal occasion. Let's go live to Nine Europe correspondent Brett McLeod, who is in Copenhagen. Brett, final preparations are underway.
They are. You can actually see them laying down grit because there could be snow coming tomorrow just in time for the big day. And tomorrow it's going to be, well, you remember when Prince Charles became King Charles 8 months ago. It's not going to be like that. There is no formal coronation. It's simply a proclamation. We saw some rehearsals today for some of the small ceremony they're putting on at Christiansborg Palace, which is the Royal Horse Guards, getting ready to do their parade tomorrow when they lead Queen Margrethe into the Parliament for a special session where she'll formally resign, only the second Danish monarch to do that in 1,000 years of history. And then Frederick will become Frederick the X and his wife will become Queen Mary, and they'll step out onto the balcony. They expect tens of thousands of people on the streets of Copenhagen when the royal couple then make their way through the streets back to their home at Frederick the VIII's palace. So it's going to be a very large occasion, low key, because it's been organised very quickly, given the Queen only announced 2 weeks ago that she was stepping down.
She did. What a day for our Princess Mary. Thank you, Brett. And to celebrate Princess Mary becoming Queen of Denmark, landmarks around Tasmania will shine bright in the Danish flag colours. The acting Premier describing the Crown Princess born and raised on the island state as a natural ambassador. The Tasman Bridge and Launceston Town Hall will be lit up in red and white. What a day for our Mary.
I know, this is huge.
Yeah, there is something about Mary.
There certainly is.
One of ours, Prince Frederick and Aussie-born Princess Mary will become the King and Queen of Denmark.
On the ground for the big day is ITV News Royal Editor Chris Shipp, who joins us now in Copenhagen. Good morning, Chris. Many rumours swirling on why Queen Margrethe is abdicating. What are insiders saying?
You know, it was a massive shock to all Danes when their queen announced on New Year's Eve that she was abdicating. It's not normal here for kings and queens to abdicate. In fact, the last time it happened was 900 years ago in 1146. We're talking about something quite historic. And once they got over the shock, I think a lot of Danes thought, you tell you what, that's not a bad idea. She's 83 years old. She can hand over to the crown prince. He'll be the new king. He's in his mid-50s. And they kind of have come to peace with the whole idea now. As for why she did it, well, there's some rumours it's because of her health. She had a back operation last year. Of course, you might have covered this story about the Crown Prince being in Madrid with another woman recently. Why he was there, we don't know. But most Danes seem to have taken the opinion, do you know what? That's their business. We don't know what he was doing, but we're not bothered. And it hasn't dented his popularity one little bit.
That is surprising. Hey, what's the public sentiment like there in Denmark? Are they happy to have an Aussie gal as their queen?
You know, that one's really easy to answer. Absolutely yes. Without exception, every single Dane that I spoke to, and of course everyone here speaks English better than I do, every single Dane says they love her. They love the fact that she is from Australia, but she's embraced the Danish language. She speaks it very well, although I'm told her children sometimes poke fun at her for her slight Australian accent. But you know, Danish is not an easy language to learn, and she's mastered it. She's taken on some good causes. They think she's very relatable. They like the way she is with people. They love her. And from later today at 3 o'clock in the afternoon Danish time, she will be Queen Mary of Denmark, but of course born in Australia.
She certainly looks the part as well. The ceremony will be commencing later tonight Australian time. How will proceedings unfold?
Do you know what? So much less extravagant than what you might have seen if you were in London covering our coronation last year. Quite a simple affair, really. The Queen, who is stepping down, will go in a carriage from her residence to the castle. She'll sign a bit of paper. The new King, Frederick the X, will stand on the balcony, wave to the crowds and give a speech. And then he and your Mary will then get in the carriage his mother just used and go back to their residence. That's pretty much it. Now, if you watch what they did in London last year with Westminster Abbey and anointing with holy oil and long services and gold carriages. None of that here. It's very simple. In fact, they don't even put the crown on their head. That only gets put on, it only gets used, incidentally, if someone dies, it goes on the coffin. So everything is much lower key here. As it's been put to me, it's all very Scandinavian, very simple, very short, very straightforward.
And the Brits are a little OTT, aren't they?
Well, you know, we like to ham up the fact that we've got these royals. They've been around for a long time. So, yeah, we put it on for the world last year.
Absolutely. It's too cold in Denmark to stay outside anyway.
Our Mary is certainly going to be doing us proud. Chris, well done. Thank you. Well, today, Princess Mary will become Queen of Denmark, making history as the first Australian-born monarch. The next chapter is an unlikely love story. It was a wedding worthy of their fairy tale. A beautiful bride, a handsome prince, and the eyes of the world firmly fixed on Copenhagen. This was the moment a girl from Tassie became Crown Princess Mary of Denmark. And watching it nearly 20 years on, it still made Mary emotional.
Oh, jeg blev faktisk ret rørt.
Admitting she was moved by the vision in an interview to mark her 50th birthday.
New kapitler.
Also revealing she was ready for a new chapter. But no one, not even Mary, expected it to come so soon. The abdication of her mother-in-law shocked the world.
Gud bevare Danmark.
And sealed Mary's fate as Queen of Denmark, a country she's made her own. It's 16,000 kilometres away from the slip-in where this story began. The year was 2000 and the Olympics were in full swing. Mary, a young marketing consultant, went out for drinks at a Sydney pub and met Frederik, the Turbo Prince.
The first time that we met or shook hands, I did not know he was the Crown Prince of Denmark. It was perhaps half an hour or so later that someone came up to me and said, do you know who these people are? I said, no. And then we found out.
Because that wasn't, I wasn't the only Crown Prince in that crowd that evening, so.
Their romance made global headlines, and Mary was transformed into a princess-to-be. This kiss in 2003, their first public confirmation they were dating.
How was your prince doing today, Mary?
Thank you.
Not as well as I was going to.
10 months on, they were engaged.
Do you feel like you're living a fairy tale?
Today, yes.
Their wedding followed, and by 2005, Mary was pregnant. Christian, the first of four children and heir to the Danish throne.
This is the space my heart wants to be.
But last November, rumours of an affair rocked the royal house after Frederik was photographed with a Mexican socialite. The couple didn't comment, and just a month on, it was confirmed Mary would be queen. But there won't be a coronation. Instead, Denmark favours a more low-key approach. Tonight, Mary will join her husband and travel to Christiansborg Palace. A council of state will take place and Queen Margrethe will abdicate. Her son will become King Frederik X, making Mary queen. An hour later, the new king and queen will address the Danish people from the castle balcony. It's a far cry from where they began.
Has it sunk in yet that you will be the next queen of Denmark?
Not completely, no.
And two decades on, Mary's on the verge of fulfilling that destiny.
Oh, I've been waiting for this one. Joining us now is the slip-in's former manager, Justin Tynan, who served the prince on that very night he met his future wife and queen. Good morning, Justin. Take us back to that incredible evening. How did you come to realise there was a prince in the pub?
Look, it was 20 long blurred years ago, but what actually happened is Frederik put over a black Amex across the bar. Now, in those days, a black Amex was few and far between. I'd actually only seen one before. So we knew that we had to look after this guy. Look, it didn't have Prince Frederik written on his Amex, let me tell you that. But as word got out, we found out that we had a prince in the pub. We had no idea who Mary was at that stage, but as time went on, we realised how the story unfolded.
So back to that night, do you remember seeing Mary with him, and were they hooking up in the corner?
Look, I'm not sure if the statute of limitations lets me go on with that, but yes, we did. We did see Mary. Absolutely stunning. But at that stage had no idea what she was going to become. Mm. Look, they were a little flirtatious, I'll tell you that much. That's about as far as I can go.
All right, the Sydney Olympics were happening at the time. What about the venue? What was it like back then? Did your feet stick to the carpet?
Yeah, look, no. They stick to the carpet now. Look, it was a brand new venue. It had just been gone under massive renovation, and it was definitely the place to be in Sydney at that time. So we had A-listers from, you know, Keanu Reeves, Tom Cruise, Nicole Kidman. It was all happening back then. Definitely the place to be. So they weren't out of place.
Okay. Hey, so when the royal couple revealed some years later that the slip-in was where they actually first met, you guys became quite the media and tourist attraction.
Yeah, look, I did something like, I don't know, 50-odd live crosses to Tokyo, Russia, London.
Wow.
It was absolutely insane. Like, countries that you would not think would care about this were, you know, contacting us to get a media run on it.
So cool, incredible to think that you were there on that fateful night.
It could
good
be
on
a
you,
movie.
Justin.
It sounds like a movie script. That is awesome. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We've got it all.
Absolute pleasure.